In any organization, we need to maintain employee attendance. Maintaining attendance in Excel sheet is the easiest way, but the attendance sheet in Excel needs lots of things to be changed every month, as dates, days, and so on. Today, we will see how to create an attendance sheet which will be fully automated, and there will be hardly something to change. Without any delays, let's start the video.
I have created this attendance sheet in advance. There are a few things like months, year. Month will be managed by drop-down. Same with the year, it will be managed by the drop-down. When we will be coming over here, it's like from first day to last date. Over here, all the dates are there from 1st till 31st. When we will change the month from Jan to Feb, it will be till 28th. And again, you will see that after 28th, it will be highlighted automatically and EOM means end of the month will be visible. When we will come to Jan, end of the month vanishes and days appear over here. When we will be going to Feb, again the same thing. When we will be going to March, weekdays are visible. And when we will be going to April, it's showing end of the month after 30th. We will be going to Jan. Here are days which will be managed along with the dates, means it's formulated. When I'll be coming to Feb, you will see that on 1st of Feb, it's Tuesday, and on 1st of Jan, it's Saturday. Again, the Saturdays and Sundays will be highlighted. I have taken 2 weeks off instead of 1 week off, means Saturday and Sunday, 2 days will be week off. Over here, things are formulated like total present, total absent, total week offs, total holidays, total paid leaves. You will notice one thing over here that total week offs, it's showing 10 days. It means I have calculated or counted Saturdays and Sundays as week offs. So total 10. Few things over here are formatted like present, it will become green, absent, it will become red, paid leave, it will become yellow, holidays, it will become indigo. This is a blank sheet. Now we will start formatting the sheet. In the beginning, we will create months, and months will be managed by the drop-down. We will be going to data, data validation. Over here, we will choose list. In source, we will type name of the months. So I have typed name of all the months. We will do OK, and our drop-down is created. Over here, we will insert year. Again, we will be going to data, data validation, list, we will type from 2022 to 2030. It's already typed, we will do OK, and our drop down is created now. We will select 2023. Over here, we will be inserting date and it will be formulated. So our formula will be plus or equal to date value, bracket open, double inverted comma, 1, double inverted comma close, and we will select this, and we will select year also. We will close our bracket and enter. You will see that first date is inserted. When we will change the month, here also first date will be changed. We will be coming over here. For last date, our formula will be plus or equal to EOMONTH, EO month or end of the month, bracket open, we will select this, comma, 0, and we will close the bracket, enter. You will see that it's showing 1st Jan to 31st Jan. If we will change the month, it will be showing 1st Feb to 28th of Feb. Now we will insert date over here from 1st till last date of the month. We will do plus or equal to, we will click our mouse over here and we will do enter. We are not going to drag this, because if we will drag this in the month of Feb, after 28th, it will be showing 1st March, 2nd March. So for 2nd or from 2nd, we are going to put a formula. Our formula will be plus or equal to if, bracket open, we will select 1st date greater than our last date, comma, 1st date plus 1, comma, double inverted comma, bracket close. Now we will insert a dollar sign before and after H2, and the command will be function F4, enter. We will change the format of the dates. We don't want month and year. Right click the mouse, format cells. We will be coming to custom and we will be typing the D over here, we will do OK. And our days are visible over here and not the month and year. We will drag this. So you can see it's visible till 31st. When we will change the month, Feb, after 28th, it's getting blank. Now we will insert formula for days. Our formula will be plus text, bracket open. We will select the date, comma, double inverted comma, DDD, double inverted comma close, bracket close, enter. We will drag this till end and our days are visible over here. We will be going to home and from here we will rotate text down. So it's looking nice and taking less space. Again, the blank cells over here in the end of the month, means after 28th, we want something to fill over there. So what we are going to do, we are going to insert something over here, means one formula of if before text, and our formula will be if bracket open this thing, means first date will be equal to blank. If it will be blank, so for blank we will give inverted comma two times, comma, double inverted comma, EOM, end of the month, double inverted comma close, comma, and we will close bracket over here till it doesn't get black or white. We will do enter. Now we will drag this once again till end. You will notice that after 28th, it's showing end of the month. When we will be coming to Jan, you will see end of the month vanishes and it shows days over here. Now we will do some formatting. We will select this sheet from here to here. We will go to conditional formatting, highlight cell rule equal to, we will type P over here and we will select green for P, means present. Okay, conditional formatting once again, highlight cell rule equal to, this time we are going to type A for absent. We will select red and do okay. Again, we will be going to conditional formatting, highlight cell rule equal to, and we will type PL for paid leave. We will select yellow for this. Okay, one more criteria is pending, that is holidays. Conditional formatting, highlight cell rule equal to H. We will go to custom format, fill, we will select one color. For font, we will select yellow color and we will do okay. Okay, so this is done. When we will type P over here, it's showing green for absent, red for PL, yellow, and for holidays, H. Means for holidays, H is there and it's showing indigo. Now we will be coming to extreme right hand side and we will insert formula for present, absent, week offs, holidays, and paid leaves. The formula which we are going to insert over here will be of COUNTIF plus COUNTIF, bracket open. We will select from first date till last date, comma, double inverted comma, P, double inverted comma, close, bracket close, enter. One thing you might have noticed that in the box where we inserted formula or in the cell where we inserted the formula, it's green in the corner. We will click on the cell. Here is a drop down. We will click over here and we will update formula to include cells. So the green part vanishes. For total absent, we are going to insert COUNTIF formula once again, plus COUNTIF, bracket open. We will select from here till last, comma, double inverted comma, A, double inverted comma, close, bracket close, enter. For total week offs, we are going to count Saturday and Sunday as week off. So our COUNTIF formula will be little bit different over here, plus COUNTIF, bracket open. We will select from here till here, comma, double inverted comma, SAT for Saturday, double inverted comma, close, bracket close, plus COUNTIF, bracket open. Again, we will select from here to here, comma, double inverted comma, SUN, double inverted comma, close, bracket close, enter. You will see that 10 is showing over here. When we will change the month, Feb, it's showing 8, means it's getting counted very properly. For holidays and for paid leaves also, we are going to insert same formula of COUNTIF what we have done in present and absent. So these things are done. One more thing before dragging these things, we will go in total week off once again and we will insert dollar in the range. Function F4, function F4, function F4, function F4, and we will do enter. Now we can drag this till end. So these things are done. Now we will be formatting the sheet and we'll highlight Saturdays and Sunday. We will click over here. We will go to conditional formatting, new rule, classic. From drop down, we will select use a formula to determine which cells to format is equal to. We will select the first day. We will give equal to double inverted comma SAT means Saturday, double inverted comma close. We will remove the first dollar. We will be going in drop down and we will go to custom format. From here, we will select red color and in pattern style, we will select a pattern. Okay. Okay. Again, we will be going to conditional formatting. New rule, classic, use of formula is equal to, we will select this, is equal to double inverted comma SUN for Sunday. We will remove first dollar. We will click on drop down, custom format. We will select red color, pattern style, this one. Okay. Okay. Conditional formatting, new rule, classic, use of formula is equal to, we will select this one once again, is equal to double inverted comma EOM means end of the month. We will remove the first dollar. We will go over here, custom format, fill, red color, pattern style, this one. Here in EOM, we want the color of the font to be yellow. So we will be going to font, color, we will select yellow. We will do OK. Again, OK. Now we will drag this till end. So our conditional formatting is done over here. We will see in the month of Jan, Saturdays and Sundays are highlighted in red. When we will be coming in Feb, after 28th, all the things are highlighted in red. We will select all this. We will go in conditional formatting, highlight cell rule equal to, and we will put EOM over here. We will select custom format, fill, red color, font, we want yellow. We will do OK and we will do OK once again. Here we will be going in Jan and we will be checking what the result we are going to get. When EOM is not mentioned over here, it's becoming white, and in month of Feb, it's becoming red after 28th. In the month of April, it's becoming red after 30th. We'll be going in Jan once again. We will be doing one more conditional formatting. We will select all this. Conditional formatting, new rule, classic, use of formula is equal to, we will select this, is equal to double inverted comma, double inverted comma. We will remove the first dollar from here. We will go to drop down and custom format. From here, we will select red color, pattern. We will select this once again. Okay. And okay. Now we will change the month and we will see what result we are going to get. See, after 28th, it's getting red. When we will come in month of April, after 30th, it's getting red. Now we will see if we are able to put something in Saturdays and Sundays. P, we are able to type. We will have to restrict this. To restrict this, we will have to click over here, means under first day, and we will have to go in data, then data validation. From here, we will have to go in custom and we will be putting a formula. Our formula is equal to, we will take this aside. We will select this, greater than, smaller than, double inverted comma, SAT, double inverted comma, close. We will take this in bracket. We will close this. Between F and 4, we will insert a dollar into bracket open. Again, we will select this, greater than, smaller than, double inverted comma, SUN, double inverted comma, close. We will insert $1 over here. We will close the bracket into bracket open. We will select this, greater than, smaller than, double inverted comma, EOM, double inverted comma, close, bracket close. We will insert dollar over here. Okay, we have selected Saturday, Sunday, and end of the month. do be restricted. Whatever we will be typing over here, we will not be able to put any data or insert any data. So this thing is done. After that, we will be going to error alert. From here, there are three options: stop, warning, and information. We have to click on stop. Over here, we have to put a title. Our title will be off day, and error message will be enjoy your off day. We will do it okay. Now we will be dragging this till end and till down. It's time to check whether we are able to put something or not. P. No, we are not able to put anything. We are getting the message off day, enjoy your off day. Cancel. We will click over here and we will type P. Okay, we are able to put present over here. When I'll be coming in the month of Feb, here after 28th, it's end of the month. I'll check if I am able to put something. P. No, I'm not able to put anything over here. So this restriction part and conditional formatting part is done. Now it's time to check our sheet. We will put P over here. It's getting green. A, it's getting red. PL, it's getting yellow. And for H, it's getting indigo. Now we will see we are able to calculate it over here or not in the end. So I'll drag this all till down. This is getting calculated very properly. You can check from here. Now our sheet is ready and it can be used anywhere.
I'm sure you must have loved the video. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you soon with a new topic. Till then, keep practicing. Bye-bye.